Hey, what's happening, guys? Today I'm going to tell you about one of my favorite upgrades that I've ever done on my muscle car, and that is a seat upgrade. Now, the original seats in this car were really nice. They were in good shape, but they just weren't comfortable. I'd notice after long car rides that my back would hurt. I would always be stiff, probably because I'm older and probably because I gained a bunch of weight from when I first bought this car. But nonetheless, I knew that I wanted to upgrade it because I really wanted to be able to drive this car and have no reason not to. So seats were a priority for me. As I started doing some research, I knew that I wanted to stick with a low back bucket, just like the original. I didn't want a racing seat. I didn't want something that was high with a high back and a headrest that was obvious that it didn't belong in this car. So I settled on these seats by TMI. I really like them. They're a pretty common seat for TMI that they make in a ton of different patterns. I got all black, so it matches my car really nice, I think, anyways. And they have really good bolster side support. But the big thing for me was that they recline. You can get the angle just right. You can slide them. The original seat slid, obviously. But these ones, you could recline and get it just right. So having put these in and now driven the car quite a bit, it's just a ton more comfortable. You can dial it in just like you would with any modern seat and get the position just right. So it makes a ton of difference. I'm more comfortable. The car has a totally different personality because of the side support. The technology and seats have obviously changed in the 50 or 60 years since mine were produced, where they had those seat springs with a burlap on it. Even done correctly, those didn't hold a candle to the comfort level of these new seats or even any modern seat if you swapped them out. But I think these seats look great. They give the car a totally different personality. They feel like I just spent a ton of money on suspension that I didn't, just to be able to keep you in the seat straight and keep you going around corners. They really like hug your body, which is nice for me. Hug your body around corners. They make it feel like a totally different car in my case. So really good upgrade, very necessary for somebody who drives their car a lot. Again, if you're just taking your car out on a weekend cruise and it's a show car, yeah, you can probably get away with the stock seats, but I want to drive my car. I want no reason not to take it for a couple hundred mile road trip and be behind the wheel a lot. So this was an important thing for me, and I'm really happy with how it turned out. Also, TMI, the company that these seats came from, they make adapters to be able to bolt it directly into quite a few cars. They didn't make it for this one, obviously. I don't think they make it for many B-bodies, but your Chevelles, your Mustangs, your Camaros, things like that, even your C10 trucks, they have kits that you don't even have to do any welding. I had to weld these up and custom fabricate it to get everything centered. I had to make sure that the driver's seat was centered on the steering wheel and measure the distance to make sure that everything was exactly correct. Had the center console to go off of for reference, but if you're doing that, you're going to really want to try to dial it in and get it correct so that the seats are positioned correctly and in the middle of their travel so that the seats can go forward far enough and they can go back far enough. So a couple things to think about if they don't have a direct bolt-in for your setup, but anyway, they turned out really good, and I'm really happy with it. They're a lot more comfortable than the old seats, so makes the car a lot more fun to drive. And it's one of those little things that you don't think is going to be a big deal, but it actually is because it's one of the things that you notice quite a bit. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this. If this was something that you liked, if you guys are into cars, you want to see muscle car stuff, we've got a lot of cool stuff coming. I've got a 47 Fleetline project coming up next. Just bought an LS for that. That'll probably be the next video that we have coming next week. Feel free to subscribe if this is what you're into. We'll see you guys in the next one. Thanks.